dusty. I want you to meet Benjamin. Well, I noticed you didn't have any friends, so I signed you up for the Guardian Angel program at church.
Your mom's smoking hot. If I play my cards right, maybe someday I'll be your real guardian.
Good morning, homeschoolers. You're really gonna enjoy the best writer's camp in the state.
I'd like to introduce you to one of the greatest science fiction authors of our time, Ronald Chevalier.
Writer-director Jared Hess' first feature, Napoleon Dynamite, had a very modest opening weekend, then stayed around in theaters for 241 days and turned into a cultural sensation. His latest film, Gentle and Broncos, had an even more modest opening and doesn't seem to be destined to turn into much. But who can tell? Benjamin is homeschooled and writes sci-fi novels aspiring to be like his idol, Ronald Chevalier, played by Jemaine Clement from Flight of the Conchords. Desperate for ideas, Chevalier takes Benjamin's book titled Yeast Lords, The Bronco Years, at a writing conference and passes it off as his own. Little else can be said of the story except that popcorn balls form one of the main subplots. Benjamin struggles with his creativity, while the world either ignores him or takes from him only selections, like a musician never appreciated but only sampled. It's impossible not to draw the connection to Hess himself, especially when independent filmmaking is brought up in the narrative. But at the same time Hess would openly examine these issues, his film is actively engaged in what might generously be called creative expression. It defies convention. Put more obtusely, it doesn't make sense. The original filmmaking competes with the message of originality. Either or might have worked, but together they mostly flounder. The most enjoyable parts of this film are by far when we're taken inside the world of Yeast Lords. Sam Rockwell plays Bronco on a quest to recover his stolen testicle and battles innumerable cyclops and mechanical reindeer. Jemaine Clement is also wonderful as the delusional sci-fi author. I give this film 3 out of 5 stars. Come back next week for my review of the post-apocalyptic drama, The Road.